Good evening. I am going to call to order this regular meeting of the Union County Board of Chosen Freeholders for Thursday, April 11th, 2019. Clerk of the Board, would you please call the roll?
Freeholder Estrada.
Present.
Freeholder Garrison. Freeholder Granados. Freeholder Hudak.
Here.
Freeholder Palmieri Mudin.
Here.
Freeholder Staton.
Here.
Freeholder Williams.
Here.
Vice Chairman Mirabella.
Present.
Chair Kowalski.
Here.
Chair, you have 7 freeholders present.
Thank you. Would you please lead us in the prayer and salute to the flag?
Humbly we ask God, the giver of peace and the lover of charity, to give the entire family of nations true agreement with his will and to grant the light of his spirit on all who work for justice and peace.
Amen. Amen.
I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Mr. Clerk, would you please read the Statement of Compliance with the Open Public Meetings Act?
The Chair wishes to announce that pursuant to the requirements of New Jersey statutes annotated Title 10, Chapter 4, Section 10 of the Open Public Meetings Act, adequate notice of this meeting of the Board of Chosen Freeholders of the County of Union has been given by mailing the annual meeting schedule for the year 2019, along with periodic changes necessitated by circumstances, to the newspapers circulating within the County of Union who are designated to receive such notice, and by posting the annual meeting schedule for the year 2019 in the Administration Building, and further by filing the annual meeting schedule for the year 2019 with the Office of the County Clerk.
Thank you. So if the time has come to do our presentations of the infrastructure awards, Freeholder Hudak, would you please join me at the front? And it's great to see so many of our mayors and public officials and administrators in the room. Thank you to everyone for coming, and thanks for the work you do all through the year. We very much appreciate it. You know that this infrastructure grant was begun when Freeholder Hudak was chair, and the funding comes out of the sale of Runnels, and what we do with it is use it for improvements in all of your towns and cities. I'm going to turn the microphone over to Freeholder Hudak because he's the one who knows most about it. Here you go.
What I know is that when you give municipalities an opportunity to invest in their roads and their downtowns, they will have the best and most innovative ideas. And so I appreciate that the Freeholders have continued to do this. This, I believe, is our fifth year doing the grant, $1.5 million per year, and that is matched with a municipal match dollar for dollar, and that doesn't necessarily need to come out of your capital or operating funds, but can be matched with grants and other dollars, $9 million in infrastructure through this grant program over the last 5 years. And I think we see it every year, and as towns are looking at their streets and their sidewalks and their downtowns and saying, how can we better our communities? And it's good to see the innovative programs that we have. So we have some checks. And okay, and we have Councilman Hund, Smith, and Toll. And to our right and our left, we have a board. We have on the video boards, we have where the grant is going. So it'll be roadway improvements in Clark. And we have the mayor of Berkeley Heights, Mayor Devaney. and that's going to be $55,000 for miscellaneous drainage improvements. Mayor?
It's like a homecoming for me. I feel comfortable for a little bit.
Mayor Bulge? And we have Steve Rinaldi, who's also the municipal engineer. But the mayor snuck in, so he gets to be in the picture.
Mm-hmm. Hold on.
Angel? You still want to be a friend of
We have the Borough of Fanwood Vice Chairman. Would you like to come up to join us? We have Eleanor McGovern, the Municipal Clerk.
It would be the first time you'd be raised out of the picture if you could do that.
You lost my ugly mug in there.
And the Borough of Garwood and Michael Disco, the Borough Engineer.
Thank you very much.
And we'll ask if Sheriff Corvelli would come up to join us for Kenilworth's presentation. And we have Lawrence Clemente, councilman. Okay, we have the City of Linden, and I see that Nick Pantina, the City Engineer, is here, as well as Councilwoman Cosby, Councilman Roman, and I don't think the Mayor is here. No. Okay. Is Frank Dan here?
No.
Okay.
Okay, brother.
Oh, we should. And Michael Disco from Borough of Mountainside.
Two for Michael.
Good job.
This might be our first real presentation.
I should go there for a picture.
Hope Smith, the Township Administrator from Hillside.
Okay. I had a beers in that town.
And Director Hanifa Johnson from Public Works, thanks to both of you for joining us.
Yes.
We have Councilman Munoz and Douglas Marvin, who is the Borough Administrator from New Providence. Freeholder Williams, would you mind coming down for Plainfield? And we have Carlos Sanchez, who's the City Administrator, and Oren Dabney, who's the Public Works Director. Okay, the City of Rahway, we have Councilman Mojica. Council Freeholder Satin, would you come on down? And we have Mayor Danzerow from Roselle. Caught her right before our coffee sip. Freeholder Mirabella, would you like to come on down? And we have Mayor Signorello from Roselle Park, and we have Andrew Casasis, who is the Borough Clerk.
Properly before you take it over here too.
I'm just saying, offices are important.
Thank you so much.
Freeholder, would you like to stay with us for a moment? And we have Mayor Smith, Councilman Rock White, and Councilman Spear.
Take care of that.
We're a little out of order, but we'll call up the Mayor of Cranford, Patrick Gibbon. Do you want to bring your daughter up with you?
She's so cheap, you have much bigger chat.
That's for you.
No, it's hilarious.
You sit through the dice.
Don't catch that one, Mayor.
We have Springfield Township, and we have Committeeman Kaiser and Linda Donnelly, the Township Clerk.
One more. We got our engineer here.
Oh,
all right.
He's a resident. He's a resident.
Come on, brother.
Triple dip.
Shared services are a good thing.
We have Union Township. I'm William Hoover, the engineer. Freeholder Paul Mary Mooted. And we have Chris McAloon, who's the township engineer from Westfield. We have Mayor Riley from Winfield Park. Mayor? We have a presentation for Summit, but they haven't gotten here yet, so we thank everyone for taking a few moments to honor the towns with these projects. We look forward to seeing the growth over the next year and hopefully another installment of this grant in 2020. Thank you.
Take care.
Bye. Bye.
Next year, we give the checks out at the end of the meeting.
I think Mayor Radis is coming, but I believe we'll get her later. She had a busy schedule. Okay.
It's like a powerful little work
Hi, Jamie.
I'm sorry, we can see you now. Don't worry about it.
No hiding for you.
Was it something I said?
At the end, I'm going to blow through the sunlight. I'm going to blow through the sunlight.
All right. Back to the regular business. May I have a motion to approve communications?
So moved, Madam Chair.
Vice Chair Mirabella, we have a second.
Second.
Thank you.
And also here.
Freeholder Granados, yes. Mr. Clerk, you've made note that
Chair, I did note that he came in just before.
You have been here for a while because you were here for the Elizabeth presentation. Okay.
Almost missed it.
Okay. Clerk of the Board, would you please call the roll?
Freeholder Estrada?
Yes.
Freeholder Granados?
Aye.
Freeholder Hudak?
Aye.
Freeholder Palmieri Mudet?
Yes.
Freeholder Staton?
Yes.
Freeholder Williams?
Aye.
Vice Chair Mirabella?
Aye.
And Chair Kowalski?
Yes.
Chair, you have 8 votes in the affirmative.
Thank you. Tonight we have an ordinance for introduction. Clerk, Mr. Clerk, would you please read the ordinance by title?
Ordinance number 806-2019, an ordinance to amend the laws of Union County Administrative Code and policies and general legislation by amending Part 1, Chapter 49, Fees, and Chapter 132, Towing.
Thank you. I'll ask that Policy Chairwoman Rebecca Williams move ordinance number 806-2019 for first reading and introduction.
Thank you, Chair. I would like to move ordinance number 806-2019 for first reading and authorize the clerk of the board to advertise same in accordance with the law. Public hearing and final reading will be held on, is scheduled to be held on April 25th, 2009.
Thank you. Seconded by Freeholder Hudak. Clerk of the board, please call the roll.
Freeholder Estrada?
Yes.
Freeholder Granados?
Aye.
Freeholder Hudak?
Aye.
Freeholder Palmieri-Mudet?
Yes.
Freeholder Staton?
Yes.
Freeholder Williams?
Aye.
Vice Chair Mirabella?
Aye.
And Chair Kowalski?
Yes.
Chair, you have 8 votes in the affirmative.
Thank you. The meeting is now open to the public for the purpose of commenting on resolutions being offered for adoption only. Kindly state your name and town of residence for the record and the resolution that you are referring to and adhere to the 5-minute time limit.
Good evening, Chair Kowalski, ladies and gentlemen of the Freeholder Board, Bruce Patterson, Garwood. Page 2, the top two, 292 and 293, I mean, these are almost the same wording resolutions. One in there says pre-scheduled and one says scheduled, and then there's a dollar amount of 6 and 7. I don't know, if just somebody could explain a little more in depth what those two are, and, you know, cost per trip. Moving down there on the same page, number 298, this is the infrastructure grant program that we just experienced, and I guess I'll thank you for the, what did Garwood get? Something like 40 grand, so thank you very 60. Much for that. Just one thing, just for the public knowledge, the last one, Summit, who didn't show up, if somebody could just give what that dollar amount was that the infrastructure grant was about, and I just want to talk a little further about it. This infrastructure grant came from the sale of Runnels, as you all know, and the sale was about $26 million. And Director Guzzo of Human Services, I remember, gave a presentation, and he was saying that there was a lot of debt outstanding for Runnels and unemployment and some other encumbrances that had to come from that $26 million. And the interesting part is, then a couple of years ago, Director Bibby Taylor said that there's actually $19 million. And I think she said $14 million sitting in this infrastructure grant
program. Excuse me,
program.
Mr. Patterson, is this about Runnels? Because that's not really...
This is about 298, the infrastructure grant program.
Okay.
And I'm talking about the money that the whatever's in there now. I mean, a couple of years ago, Bibby Taylor mentioned $14 million. But to me, after all the encumbrances from Director Guzzo, it was actually supposed to be about $4.5 million. So somehow you came out with $19 million... roughly, you know, I've been giving it out at $1.5 million clip every year with a matching grant, and I'm glad you mentioned that in public. It's a matching grant, so the municipalities also had to match the $1.5 million, and that's the issue here. You're forcing the municipalities to more or less come up with money to match the $1.5 million. At the same time, you didn't pay off the bonding debt of the Runnels Hospital sale that was there, you know, before the hospital was sold. And so not only are you forcing the towns to pay off another $1.5 million matching, you have this bonding money that now is just incurring debt service for actually nothing. Nothing. We don't have an asset against it. So right now, I mean, financially, I mean, this looks good on paper, but you're basically banging the residents, the taxpayers, for a lot of money. And my only suggestion, I've made this before, is instead of making it a match, a fifth of, you know, dollar for dollar, I mean, really, you should just be giving out this, whatever's left, $14 million, whatever it is, and give it out to the municipalities where they don't have to match. 299, right below it, just a question, there's a word obligate in there as to obligate an additional $375,000, and I'm just wondering what that word obligate means. Another one, 300, right below it, and another question about wording. Director Zuber had mentioned that qualified sports facilities management was stepping down and they were relinquishing the contract. So you gave it to Kemper Sports. I'm just wondering, what does that mean, relinquishing the contract? I'd like some kind of explanation as to just what went on from one, you know, from sports facility to Kemper. Something happened there. Sure. I'd like your explanation. Number 301 on page 3, it's a resolution, Lisa Bonanno versus County of Union. Hopefully, Attorney Barry can at least give us an overview of what this is about without getting into the details, because I know he can't give the details. The last one I actually have is on the bottom of page 3. Number 312, Deputy Mayor Florio of Union, he got a nomination into Elected Officials Hall of Fame. I think I've seen this before, of course. But I'm just wondering, where is this Hall of Fame located? Is there a Facebook site or an internet site I can go on to take a look at it? And would anybody know of what the criteria is to get into the Elected Officials Hall of Fame? So that's it. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Chairman?
Yes.
Would you mind if, would you, could I address the comments towards the infrastructure grant?
Yes, please.
To answer Mr. Patterson's question, Summit's grant was for $95,000. And I mean, Director Taylor, you can come up to correct me if I'm wrong, but if it's my understanding that we had to set aside funds from the Runnels sale to pay off any outstanding bond debt, and that was done as part of the transaction. And then in regard to the match, because it's more of a policy question, the reason we do the match on the grant is most municipalities have some sort of capital program, and many of those capital programs involve grants, they may involve corporate gifts, they may involve other sorts of fundings, many of those types of fundings require some other match. So in many of the communities, this frees up additional dollars that are already spoken for in their budget. It actually creates budget flexibility. So I think it's a good policy. We've done this with the Open Space Kids Rec Trust grants. The towns are happy with it, and it gives them an opportunity to prioritize projects and maximize their budgets, and I stand by it. And I think tonight we're at $4.5 million in infrastructure with a match that has meant $9 million in better roads, bridges, and downtowns in Union County. Thank you, Chair.
Thank you, Freeholder. Director Anderson, would you like to come up and explain the questions about wording on a few of those resolutions?
Through you, Chair. Resolution 292, the wording is for, this is inroads of opportunity, so it's mental health services. We provide pre-schedule, so this paratransit is picking up clients from their home, taking them to their care and counseling meetings, and returning them back to their home. So for 292, the anticipated revenue was about $31,000, but the average is 20 to 25 clients, an average of 234 rides per year. So it's back and forth along with their treatment plan. That's the same for Resolution 293. It's for rehab. So it's Bridgeway Rehab doing the same type of services, mental health, to and from their homes, and it's pre-scheduled appointments. So these are revenue-based agreements with paratransit and the nonprofit provider.
Thank you, Director.
You're welcome.
County Manager, you wanted to address the Hall of Fame?
Sure. Thank you, Chairman. The information is on the New Jersey League of Municipalities website, njlm.org, and it will list the requirements and all the other information you were looking for.
Okay.
There's 13 nominees this year.
Thank you. And County Council Barry?
The banana matter involves a personnel matter relative to civil service titles and to PERS entitlement.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Seeing no other, no one else to question, I will move on to the next portion of the meeting, which is Freeholder sponsored. No, we're done with that. Okay. So may I have a motion to adopt resolutions 219, 2002 through 219, 312?
So moved. Second.
Okay, moved by Freeholder Granados and seconded by Freeholder Staten. Clerk, would you please call the roll?
Freeholder Estrada?
Yes.
Freeholder Granados?
Aye.
Freeholder Hudak?
Aye.
Freeholder Palmieri Mudeg?
Yes.
Freeholder Staten?
Yes.
Freeholder Williams?
Aye.
Vice Chairman Mirabella?
Aye.
And Chair Kowalski?
Yes.
Chair, you have 8 Freeholders voting in the affirmative on all resolutions.
Thank you. At this time, I'd like to open the meeting for the purpose of the public to comment on any governmental issue that a member of the public feels may be of concern to the county residents. Kindly state your name and town of residence for the record and stick to the 5-minute time limit. Yes, it is. Okay. Good evening.
What, I got 5 minutes, 3 minutes?
Yes, five minutes.
Okay. As I said, good evening for y'all as a new.
Good evening.
I come before you.
Excuse me, sir, would you just give us your name and town of residence?
Yes, I'm sorry. Christopher Nelson. I live in Elizabeth, 746 Tomber Street. And as I say, I come before you just if I can make mention of some things that we'd like to bring to your attention, if you don't mind. As I said, I come before you as the founder of the organization called Citizens Going Forward. I have a few character letters I'd like to present to you all, to the board members, that is. And it will speak volumes about my character, and also as me being an honorable man representing the city of Elizabeth. And of course, I am a law-abiding citizen. And I received an email of denial from the Chosen Freeholders March 22nd of this year that there will be no financial support for our ongoing event, which will be hosted at Montana Park, hopefully. The email concluded stating, thank you for having an interest in partnering with the Board of Chosen Freeholders. In other words, it seems to show really no interest in partnering with the Citizens Going Forward organization. And all due respect, Ms. Betty Jane Koleski, Chairwoman, I reached out to you January 7th through February 11th of this year, and I spoke to Ryan on several occasions. I even sent you an email, phone messages, and as I said, left it with Ryan. Till this day, I haven't gotten a courtesy call from either one, and it's kind of like, you know, uncertain about where we're going, if we're going to be partners. And I'm here before you to see how we can bridge that gap to where we could continue to work together, because after all, we have done some great work. And like I said, the letters were from prominent leaderships in our community would tell you that. We're going to leave those with you. And I left names of individuals I believe are deserving to be acknowledged by the Chosen Freeholders in the email to directed to you. For for their contribution towards society, helping invest in our communities. I know this request is doable because I invited the ABA professional basketball organization to the city of Elizabeth, and they were given a certificate commendation of appreciation by the chosen freeholders on behalf of citizens going forward. Every year it seems to get tougher for citizens going forward to host our annual Goodwill Festival. We are faced with financial constraints, including on our vendors, supporters, sponsors, volunteers. We request a mobile stage for our performers. Every year we get less than that. We get a makeshift wagon. We as an organization provide free services, free basketball clinic, free basketball tournaments, karate demonstration, bouncy houses. We also created revenue for the county and the city of Elizabeth, including local businesses, when we have our events. We understand Freeholders events is first priority, especially when it comes to supporting board members' agenda, who also has nonprofit status. Plainfield receives financial support for their outdoor event every year. You support Roselle Hillside Linden, but can't support an outdoor event. Citizens going forward has legal legitimate status as a nonprofit organization under Section 501c3 status by the state of New Jersey. The first year out of 2015, it was said to me by Mr. Pelletier we would need to prove ourselves to the board of chosen freeholders for financial support. We have exceeded beyond the expectations with limited resources. We are always working in compliance with the county sheriff maintenance crew. We have zero incidents from the public participation. My opinion, we've proven ourselves to be worthy of financial support from the county. We are responsible, professional adults. We were honored the privilege to host a basketball tournament for the county children's disability ground opening playground at Montana Park. I want to thank the director, Mr. Ron Zuber, again, for allowing citizens going forward to be a part of something dear and special to our hearts. I'm not asking for the keys to the city of Elizabeth, but I am asking for the keys to your hearts, which I know you all have, We shouldn't have to feel as though we need to campaign for your support or petition when, after all, everything we do is for the betterment, helping our community, which is a fear for all our young and middle-aged adults and seniors. We want to thank you in advance for any support given going forward. I wish to wish you all peace and many blessings ahead. Thank you for your time.
Thank you, Mr. Nelson. And Mr. Zuber, who's the parks director, is sitting in the back.
Yes, I know.
Would talk with him, and we can try to, you know, figure out exactly what's gone on with the requests that you made, and we'll see what we can do to help, okay?
Well, yeah, I appreciate that, and Mr. Pelletier seems to make that decision too as far as financial support that we can use this year, because like I said, it would be greatly appreciated if we can get that help. And then also with the importance of the people that labor with me, the names that I sent you, would you please look into that?
Okay.
I would appreciate it.
All right, thank you. Thanks for coming tonight.
All right, appreciate it.
If you want to, when we're done with the meeting, Mr. Zuber will come over and talk to you. You don't have to go walking all around. So just have a seat. Okay. Mayor Radis, thank you for coming. The timing was a little bit off, but we'll talk to you in a bit. Anyone else for public comment?
Good evening, Chair Kowalski, ladies and gentlemen of the Freeholder Board, Bruce Patterson Garwood. These books look familiar, don't they? Anyway, now, just first, there were two resolutions
Two resolutions that were missed that I asked questions. It was actually four wording that I just needed clarification. One was 299. It was the word obligation to obligate an additional $375,000. That one I didn't get hear what that word meant. And then the other one was the sports facilities management relinquishing a contract with Kemper Sports. And I was wondering what is relinquishing a contract mean? You said Director Zubin was here. Honestly, he's the one that actually mentioned the words. So hopefully he'll come up after I finish speaking to clarify that. I'll tell you, it must be a record last week. It was like 60 minutes long, the meeting, by the way. I just wanted to mark. And that had two presentations in it. So, I mean, you know, thank you very much for keeping these meetings short. I'm probably the problem that makes the meetings long, but that's how it is. The public gets to speak. The budget. Of course, you released the budget, and as you know me, over the years, I've been looking at it. And back in December, it was interesting. Back in December, I actually said that the surplus that's going to be remaining is probably going to hit $75 million, and the running fund balance is probably going to hit $100 million. And sure enough, I'm looking in the book, and I'm looking in, its running fund is $103, and surplus is $78. So, I mean, you know, I'm calling these numbers. And the reason why I can be so accurate, and by the way, these are not good numbers, is because you're just accruing money without actually doing anything of good for the taxpayers. And what do I mean by that? Well, this year you're actually increasing, I think you adjusted it down to maybe about $6 million. So you're increasing taxes by $6 million. The taxpayers have to pay the $6 million. But at the same time, going to the surplus, and I'll probably come up with a chart another time to give to you, but going to the surplus actually increased $12 million. So you're increasing the surplus $12 million, and you're increasing taxes by $6 million. And that's the issue. And this is what I've been saying, that there are no financial people on this board that can grasp how to work the finances. I think we finally have one with financial background, so thank you very much, Freeholder, Mooted. Nobody else really shows any promise. Adrian Mapp, who was on the Freeholder board, I mean, he was great. He was starting to ask questions, financial questions, and the next thing you know, it came time for his election, and he didn't get the line, you know, in politics as it is. But what I'm saying is that if you're going to increase surplus by $12 million, and $6 million of that is taxpayers' money, that's telling me that you do not have to increase the taxes at all. You can zero it out, and I've been saying this before. You can zero it out, and still your surplus would increase about $6 million. I've had a Freeholder here, I think it might have been last year when I was talking about it, saying, oh, surplus, that's actually a good thing. I can't believe you're actually criticizing surplus. Well, no, I'm not criticizing the surplus. You can still increase the surplus by $6 million with a flat tax. Summit would come down from the mountain a couple years ago, and they'd be crying about their tax burden. And you know, they kept saying you might be able to do a flat tax. I mean, there is an easy possibility. Zero tax increase, and your surplus still increases by $6 million to the tune of $78 million. $78 million. That's like almost 20%, about 18% of the budget is just this surplus. Is it good? Yeah, it's great. But at the same time, you're banging the taxpayers for no reason at all. No reason at all. No reason. And yet you're going to hit us. See, this is the problem. You guys just don't understand. We're taxpayers. I don't know where you guys are. I guess you pay taxes. Or maybe you don't because maybe you have an inside. No, I'm only kidding. But I'm sure you do pay taxes. Not to Union County, though.
What are you talking about?
What am I talking about? Who are you? 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 I feel really sad about you because they keep putting you as financial.
Mr. Patterson, yes, let's get back
right
to your point.
The guy's useless. I've called him a pig before because all he is self-serving.
Personal attacks can be avoided.
Let's the budget.
Zero budget, and I'm talking to the finance chair through you. Yeah. Zero tax increase.
You can sit down, ma'am.
Yes. Thank you, Mr. Patterson. Mr. Zuber, I Would you please come up and explain what the issue is with Kemper Sports and relinquishing a contract?
Through you, Chairman. In 2017, we started a two-year contract with SFM to run our concessions at Warnaco Park. With 4 months left to go in their contract, they had decided they no longer wanted to be involved with us, to be a part of this contract. We had Kemper Sports already running a similar sports operation, and they were standing by, and they just took over the contracts.
Thank you.
Chair?
Yes.
May I just make a quick comment? When I spoke a few moments ago regarding the infrastructure grant, I was incorrect. I had stated that we had spent $4.5 million from the Runnels Fund in grants over the past 5 years. That was an incorrect number. It's been $7.7 million that has come out of the Runnels surplus account and directly to municipalities for AIDS, which means $14.4 million in infrastructure improvements. Thank you.
Thank you. And can we have the deputy county manager to talk about number 299?
Through you, Madam Chair, we receive grant dollars from various sources. We assign or obligate those to be used for specific purposes. That's what obligate means.
Right. Thank you. Okay. So I will close this portion of the meeting and ask County Council to make us. Oh, is there someone else who wants to make a comment? Okay.
My name is Jeffrey Taylor. I'm a resident of Linden, New Jersey. I'm just presenting the letters that Chris Nelson had spoke about earlier to the clerk.
Okay, thank you very much. Do we do a suspension of the rules for the Okay. Let's call up Mayor Radist from Summit, since I gave you the wrong timing, and we'd like to present you with your infrastructure grant. So,
Mayor, could you just tell us where the funds are going to go for this project?
Sure, be happy to. We have an area in town, it's not all that large, but it's called Wallace Road, and the residents are under severe water damage. And I mean, there can be a foot or so of water in their backyards. And it's not that big an area in town, but it really needs to be improved in the drainage in the road. It's not too far from the Canoe Brook Country Club, which sends its water downhill to us, and there's not a whole lot we can do about it. So this is wonderful because we really, really appreciate it, and those neighbors are just ecstatic that finally we're going to be able to help them. So thank you very much, and I'm down from the mountain, but I'm happy to be here.
Thank you, Mayor. We know you had a busy day with your Summit County or Summit Government Day.
Yes, and thank you.
And I'm grateful for your budget, your proposed budget. Thank you. Speaking for the city of Summit.
Thank you, Mayor.
Thank you, Mayor.
Thank you, Mayor.
It's the kindest thing we've heard from Summit.
Okay. So now we will just deal with the need for an executive session tonight, and County Council, would you please make your statement?
Thank you. Thank you, Madam Chair. Pursuant to the provisions of the Open Public Meetings Act, a public body may enter into executive session for the purpose of discussing certain enumerated subjects. This board now wishes to enter into executive session for the purpose of discussing attorney-client privilege communication and discussions relative to possible settlement in the matter of Stephen Rapella versus Union County Police Department et al. The minutes of the executive session shall be separated from the minutes of the open public session. The minutes of the executive session, redacted as appropriate and necessary, shall be made available in approximately 30 days. The clerk to the board shall retain the original minutes until such time as the limitations, confidential limitations, have been removed, at which time they shall be made available. Upon the affirmative vote of the majority of the members present, may enter into executive session, and upon the board's return, it will not take any formal action on the matter discussed.
Thank you. May I have a motion to enter into executive?
So moved. Second.
Moved by the vice chair, seconded by Freeholder Hudak. Clerk of the board, would you please call the roll?
Freeholder Estrada?
Yes.
Freeholder Granados?
Aye.
Freeholder Hudak?
Aye.
Freeholder Palmieri Mudek?
Yes.
Freeholder Statton?
Yes.
Freeholder Williams?
Aye.
Vice Chairman Mirabella?
Aye.
And Chair Kowalski?
Yes.
Chair, you have eight votes in the affirmative.
Thank you. Okay, we'll now enter into executive session.
Second.
Thank you, Vice Chair.
You're welcome. Just trying to help you, Madam Chair.
Is that Freeholder Williams or Granados?
Me, Williams.
Freeholder Estrada?
Yes.
Is this to return to the meeting? Freeholder Granados?
Aye.
Freeholder Hudak?
Aye.
Freeholder Palmieri Mudek?
Yes.
Freeholder Staten?
Yes.
Freeholder Williams?
And the group.
Oh. Aye.
Vice Chair Mirabella?
Aye.
And Chair Kowalski?
Yes.
So you have eight votes in the affirmative.
Thank you. And we will move on to freeholder reports and comments. Freeholder Palmieri Mudek, would you like to start tonight?
Sure. I just want to express my deepest sympathies to the family of Dr. Derek Nelson from Westfield High School, our principal who passed away this week. Wanted to send my thoughts and prayers to the entire Westfield community. That's it tonight.
Thank you. Freeholder Estrada?
Yes, I copy what it was just said by my colleague next door, and I back the rest of my time. Thank you.
Thank you. Freeholder Staten?
Yes, I'll thank my time, Madam Freeholder. Thank you.
Thank you. Freeholder Granados?
My condolences to you on the major loss in Westfield. Okay. Thank you, Chair.
Thank you. Freeholder Williams?
My condolences as well. I do have one thing, and that is that beginning on April 25th, the Freeholder Board and Assemblywoman Linda Carter will be launching a new mobile office for a nonprofit called We Are One New Jersey. We Are One New Jersey provides free, affordable immigration-related services to the public, and that includes guidance on applying for a citizenship, registering to vote, and navigating the Deferred Action for Childhood Arrivals program, also known as DACA. The office is located in Assemblywoman Carter's office, which is at 200 West 2nd Street, Suite 102, the county building on Front Street. It will be open the last Thursday of each month from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m., again starting on April 25th. And any Union County resident can use this satellite office. We, of course, also have a main office here in Elizabeth at 288 North Broad Street. And for more information, residents can contact the program coordinator, Elizabeth Montez, at 908-249-4360. And that concludes my comments. Thank you.
Thank you, Freeholder. Freeholder Hudak?
Thank you, Chair. I too wish to extend my condolences to Dr. Nelson and his family.
Thank you. Vice Chair?
Yes, thank you, Madam Chair. As I join my colleagues on the board, recognizing the passing of Dr. Nelson, we should probably keep in mind also, as last week we honored Organ Donation Month, and Dr. Nelson was actually in the process of donating to someone he didn't even know in France, and that makes this story even more heartbreaking. He was trying to do something good, and something bad happened to him. So, moving on, we're getting close to the summer season, I'd like to remind everyone that there's positions available for manager, assistant manager, and lifeguards at our public swimming pool, the Walter Ulrich Memorial Pool in Rahway River Park. Ulrich Pool provides county residents with a rewarding work environment that builds the value of experience in people skills as well as management and emergency response. If you're looking for a rewarding summer experience, please contact the Parks Department at 908-527-4824. On a different note, also our sensory-friendly theater series continues on Sunday, April 28th, with a performance of the musical Henry and Mudge at the Union County Performing Arts Center. It's one of those special events we have planned for April in recognition of Autism Awareness Month. For more information about our upcoming events, please call the Office of Persons with Disabilities and Special Needs at 527-4807. And I will note, too, that in Summit, over the weekend, I had the opportunity to visit an art gallery, the Peanut Gallery, where they highlighted artwork of residents with autism. And it was quite an event. This is the third year they've done this. A young guy, he's a junior in Summit High School, Zachary Brooks, who this board has honored several times in the past for his raising the awareness of autism. His brother, his twin brother, has autism, and he is quite a young man and a great advocate for his brother and all people with that disability. Just the last note that I have, Madam Chair, is I was recently in attendance at the Union County College Foundation Scholarship Dinner just the other night, joined by Freeholder Granados and Freeholder Williams, where the school brings the donors of scholarship and the recipients of those scholarships together. And I think Freeholder Granados mentioned it was over $1.1 million in scholarships that were awarded for Union County College students. And it was great to be in attendance, to see the generosity on behalf of the donors and the excitement on the students' place, because otherwise they might not even be able to attend college. So, terrific event, and I was glad to be there. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Thank you, Vice Chairman. County Council, any comments?
No comments. Thank you, Madam Chair.
County Manager?
No comments.
Okay, well, I have a few comments. First off, I am happy to report that the DHS action line is now up and running. This is a new action line run through our Department of Human Services. Trained staff will provide personal one-on-one guidance on services for seniors, job training, homeless prevention, and mental health and addiction issues, among other topics. And it also provides human services clients with a portal for resolving issues related to benefits and payments. So the DHS action line is available during regular business hours, Monday through Friday, and that's at 888-845-3434. That's 888-845-3434. I feel the need to make a personal comment here. I'm not speaking for the freeholders, but speaking as a Cranford resident, I do have some concerns about the Verizon cell tower planned for construction on the Union County College campus in Cranford. Residents of the area have told me that they had no voice in the process of siting this tower. And the Township of Cranford hasn't had the opportunity to review the construction. Verizon has not come before Cranford's planning board or zoning board to allow the township to weigh the pros and cons of putting a 130-foot cell tower in our town. And for some years, the phone companies have explored building a cell tower in this vicinity. They put up proposals to build near Lenape Park, at first on the Westfield side and later on the Cranford Swim Club property. And both times, with my support, residents spoke out against the cell tower, and the plans were apparently withdrawn. Now, cell connection at the college needs to be fixed, and the safety of students and staff must be protected. There have been incidents where communications on campus have failed, and certainly no one, including myself or any Cranford resident, wants to see any unsafe situations go unaddressed at the college or anywhere else. But There are some questions remaining about the cell tower, and I urge Verizon and any other companies involved with it to open communications with the public, hold a meeting where residents can voice their concerns and get some answers. So that's what I have to say about the cell tower, and I will also offer my condolences to the Nelson family, Freeholders, Staten, and Palmieri Moodit, and I attended the vigil at Westfield High School last night. It was very moving. The students spoke to our hearts, and the choir sang really beautifully. So we know that that Dr. Nelson will long be remembered. With that, I'll conclude my comments and ask for a motion to adjourn. All in favor?
Aye.
All right, thank you. And we'll conclude the meeting.